Finally, Excel is getting true dark mode, an official feature, not the workaround where you set the cells black yourself or the half-baked dark theme that we have now where the cells aren't even dark, which is 90% of the interface. But rather, it's getting a true honest-to-God dark mode. At the moment, the feature is only in the beta version of Excel, but don't worry, I'll show you how to enable the beta updates so you can get the feature right now if you want. It's slightly different steps depending on whether you have Microsoft Office, the business version versus personal. I will go over all that. Toggling the dark mode is mostly straightforward with a couple caveats. It's only going to show the dark mode option if the rest of Excel is using the dark theme, which you can tell it is if the ribbon bar is black up here. And you can get it like that by going into the file, account, and then either setting the Office theme directly to black, or you can set it to use system theme and then it will match Windows. And Windows theme is set in the settings and then personalization, colors, and then under choose your mode. You can either set it straight up dark mode across the board in Windows, or if you do custom, you can also do default app mode as dark, and then that is when the dark mode toggle will appear in Excel. And it will remember if you toggle it on, so it's not like you have to keep pressing it. Now, as for how the colors work in dark mode, it's not a simple inversion, fortunately. It's a bit more sophisticated. As a test, I painstakingly went through and created a bunch of test cells that use all the default colors from this dropdown. And you can see that when toggling the dark mode back and forth, it keeps the colors, but adjusts their brightness effectively. So you still get to keep the true color you're using. It's just a bit more visible, which is good because if you were literally just inverting it, orange things would turn blue, green things would turn purple, so they were smart about it. It seems that the contrast ratio and how easy it is to see the different text colors in dark mode is pretty similar to how it is in the light mode counterpart of that color. For example, if I set the font color to white 5% darker, it's hard to read in light mode, and then it's also hard to read in dark mode. So that's good consistency, I like that. And also, if you're wondering, if you set the color of the text, it will stay that color regardless of the cell fill color, just like it does in light mode. So it's just a one-time adjustment of the color. I also noticed that if you set a color to pure white, it doesn't actually result in pure black, and therefore it doesn't actually appear invisible like it would in light mode. And then also setting a color to pure black does not result in a pure white either. And I guess that's just the way they decided to do it. Now, when it comes to setting the cell background colors, the fill color, those show up the same just as the font colors for each of them. And you can see here, I sort of did a similar thing to before, except with the fill color. And then I also added versions with white text set and black text set, so you can kind of get an idea of what it looks like in dark mode. Now, the dark mode does not apply to images, only text and fill color and stuff like that. And for charts, it's not fully there. It doesn't replace the background color of the chart, only the text and for the data in the chart, not even the colored lines. Now, you could change the theme of the chart to be a darker theme, but then it still changes the text color. So I hope they fix that and just have some kind of consistency, either have the charts be all or nothing dark mode. Out of curiosity, I wanted to know the full spectrum of the dark mode color changes. So I created a worksheet that does fill all the cells with just the spectrum of color. I used AI to write a Visual Basic script for that. And when you toggle into dark mode, you can see how every color is converted to the dark mode colors. After some messing around in Photoshop, it seems what they did is inverted the colors and then shifted the hues 180 degrees, technically speaking, so that it basically inverted it but then kept the original color hue. And then they probably did some additional gamma correction or brightness correction that I couldn't quite replicate, but I got sort of close. And I think for these splotchy reasons, you definitely noticed, I think these are special areas that they manually changed so that it would be more accurate colors. Because if you notice around there, the dark blue mode, if you had just inverted it and shifted the hues, it would turn into more of a pink and the yellow one would be brown. So they probably wanted it to just be more consistent colors. That's my theory why those look different. All right, so how do you actually get the beta version of Excel? It's gonna be slightly different steps depending on personal versus business. The business one is actually just a couple extra initial steps. So we'll do personal first. All you have to do is in Excel, you go to File, Account, and then look for Microsoft 365 Insider. It's an option on the right, and then select Join Microsoft 365 Insider. Check the box at the top, and then set the channel dropdown to beta channel, and then just click to agree, and then you can click okay. And if you ever want to go back, you simply use the change channel button and then just uncheck this. It should automatically start updating, but if it does not, you should be able to just go to the update options and select update now. And then after it finishes, you can launch Excel, and then you should see that it now says beta channel. And it seems that you have to close Excel and reopen it once more to get the toggle to show up. So once you close it again and do that, the dark mode toggle should show up in the view tab. And again, only if the rest of Excel's in that dark theme. Now, if you're using Microsoft 365 for business, it's gonna be slightly different. There's some initial extra steps you have to do, because if you go to the accounts menu, you'll notice that there is no Join Insider option by default, because we need to make a quick registry tweak for a policy. Businesses have additional settings for whether or not users can join the insider channels and update channels. So we just have to give ourselves the permission. This is assuming you have administrative privileges on your computer. So like if it's a personal device, but they give you an Excel license. Now, as for these registry changes, Microsoft has an article where they go more in depth about how all this works. And there are four commands they tell you to run. I'll put the link in the description. You basically just copy them one by one, paste them into command prompt running as admin, and it should work. And now after you run those commands and restart Excel, you'll see a new option in that menu called update channel. And then you can then set that again to beta channel, just like you saw before. And if you ever want to go back to the previous one, you can just uncheck this again. From there, after selecting the beta channel, it's the same process. You just wait for it to update, launch Excel. It should say beta channel, then you gotta close it and reopen it again, and then it should show up. Now, if you do not have administrative privileges on your computer, like it's a work device managed by your company, you would have to go to your IT admin and talk to them. I do have one additional tip. If you wanna get the dark mode button to appear in the home tab, not in the view tab, all you have to do is right click somewhere on the ribbon and then click customize the ribbon. And then on the right hand box, click to highlight the home area and then click new group, and then you can rename that to something like my group or whatever. And then with that new group selected, on the left hand side, go to the drop down and select all tabs, and then go to view and then dark mode, and then select switch modes and click add, and that will add the switch modes button to your new custom group in the home tab. Now, it still will only let you use the button and toggle it if the rest of Excel is in the dark theme, so it'll just be disabled, but at least you can see that it's there. So if you want to do that, you can. Otherwise, you can always just go to the view tab. So hopefully you guys are excited as I am, finally. I've been blinded too many times by Excel at night, even with the monitor brightness all the way down. It was annoying. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up. Let me know what you think down in the comments. I'll be reading down there. And if you want to keep watching, next up, I'd recommend where I talked about a meme that took me about 2 days to make because I made a whole app for it. And you can actually use it too now because it's kind of cool. So I'll put that link right there you can click on. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.